Praise God. Mukama wa fe bazwe. Mbalamusiza mu linnya lya Mukama wa fe Yesu. Era kansubire muli balungi mu mwoyo n'omubiri. Nange nebaza Katonda nti onaku luno lungi era alumpadde. Kasita munnange tubatussa. Ekitiibwa kya Katonda tukimuddiza. Jukira n'okussa kikakata ku ye. Amen. Njagala kubeebaza mwenna abamaze kutuuka ku mukutu nga omuweereza munnaffe Jeke Jonathan Mukama akuwa omukisa ng'asinzidde Uganda. Twebaza Mukama olw'obulamu bwaffe, twebaza Mukama olwa famili zaffe, twebaza Mukama olwa kimu ekigenda mu maaso eri obulamu bwaffe. Ffe baani okubanga ssaawa zino tulina akakisa okwogera naawe, okwogera n'ono n'oli. Ekyo kiba kitiibwa kya Katonda lwakuba Katonda yagaba bino ebintu. Toyinza kukyeteekamu nga teyakikuwa. Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Nzikiriza nkwebaze nti Mukama yeebale kuwa omukisa. Halleluya. Amen. Simanya, how is it now? Bajja kungamba. I'm sorry, video ebadde dark. Naye kati nsuubira eri fine. Ojja kubeera ngamba. Ekyuma kino si ekirungi ennyo. Naye nsuubira mangu nnyo. Tujja kuba nga tufuna ekyuma kiri. Is it you, Dak? Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Halleluya. Kancekinga endabe. Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Bagambye tikiri Dak, huya Dak. Halleluya, halleluya, halleluya. Simanyi. I don't know how it is now, but since we are in the process, I think to jagumi siriza tambuliro kuba gambye video dark. Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Simanyi kati nga bwe kiri nja kuba ndaba. Naye munansonyiwa video kuba ddaaka, naye mbasuubiza mangu nnyo ebyuma bijja kuba biri birungi nga video evaayo nga bwe yagalibwa. Otherwise prophetess weebale okutugamba nti video eri ddaaka, ate ne brother Jonathan Jeke Mukama akuwa omukisa kubanga otweyunzeeko. Munzikirize njogereko ku bigambo bino nga sinaba kugenda mu kigambo kya leero. Waakiri wano nti eri bbeta kitiibwa kya Mukama. Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Nzikiriza nkubuulire programu zaffe nga bwe zitambula. Buli ssaawa mukaaga tubeera ne lunch hour. Buli ssaawa mukaaga eza South Africa tubeera ne lunch hour. Ye kuva ku Monday mpaka ku Saturday. Sunday tetuba ne lunch hour. Kuva ku Monday mpaka ku Saturday. Essaawa ya South Africa, eya Uganda ziba 7, eza China ziba 12. Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. I think neya America ziri 12 ezoku America ziri 12 ezokumacha. Yes, kumacha 12 ezokumacha. Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Halleluya. Then buli mukaago ogw'ekiro tuba ne a prayer that unveils a new day. Tuyingira mu lunaku ne Sara. Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Then buli lwa kubiri saawa 12 kitundu tubaako n'abaweereza abatwekulembera mu programu y'abaana. Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Programu ey'abaana tubaako n'abaweereza abatukulembera mu ekyo saawa 12 kitundu. Programu yetukoze bulungi, abaana bayize, abantu bayize nnyo ebintu byebabadde tebamanyi, so twebaza Mukama olw'ekyo. Then nzikiriza nkubuulire nti buli lwakuna nga leero saawa 12 kitundu tubeera ne program buuza musumbawo. Waliwo ekibuuzo, waliwo olunyiriri, waliwo ekyakusumbuwa, waliwo kyewanoonya mu Bayibuli kikyabuze. Buuza omusumba. Tubeerawo kuva 12 kitundu ne tuwuliriza ebibuuzo, mwoyo n'atulungamya bye tuddamu ne tubiddamu kye tuba tetutegedde ne tukiwa obudde. Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Then buli lwa mukaaga ne sande saawa 12 kitundu tubaako ne surveying the word of God, oba okulambula ekigambo kya Katonda, oba okusoma mu kitabo kino ekitukuvu kyetwandiise Bible study. Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Halleluya. Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Tubeerako ne short scriptures mu viso we ne tubanga tusoma busomi. Nzikiriza nkubuulire tuvira ko ne eclipse z'abana mukama wa feyebazibwe eclipse ze z'abato bane z'abakuru wabawe bibayigiriza nga encouragement word bituzamu amanyi bituyimusa bitereza mukama yebazibwe ne program ndala nyingi zigenda kubanga zijja tulabenga buli kimu kyonna tukitusa kisenge nga mwoyo mutukuvu bwanaba atwekulembedde simanyi oba echa lidaka oba kateri beta. You'll be telling me that side because my device is not that clear. Mukama yebazibwe nzikiriza leero tugende mu kigambo kya leero echa thinking God with all your heart. Kunonya mukama n'omutima gwo gwonna. Kunonya mukama n'omutima gwo gwonna. Hallelujah. Okuvenju bajeva okutusa jegenda zena sinzanga mukama. 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 Kale musinze na sinzanga mukama, na sinzanga mukama. Okuvenju bajeva okutusa jegenda zina sinzanga mukama. Na sinzanga mukama, na sinzanga mukama. Okuvenju bajeva okutusa jegenda zina sinzanga mukama. Kitafu omulungi tukwebaza olunaku lwaleero. Kiriza ebigabyo tugenda okubanga tugabana. Leka mwoyo w'omutukuvu yaba atwekulemberamu byonna bisobole okugasa obulamu bwaffe. Mwoyo w'omutukuvu leka atwekulembere, leka atuyigirize, leka ategeeze ebyamazima ate kitaffe omulungi. Nsaba leka omusaayi gwo ogwayika ku muti gutwetoloole ffenna tuleke kutuukibwako akabi nga tuli mu kigambo kino, newankubadde omubi okukiremesa okukituukako. Tusabira network mukama, tusabira aba bagenda kuba bagiwuliriza kati nga tuli live n'aba naagiwuliriza oluvannyuma. Leke tukole obulungi, ekitiibwa n'ettendo kikuddire, kuyitira mu mwana wa Yesu Kristo mukama waffe. Amen. Ya nzikiriza tugende mangu mu kyawandiikibwa, tukisanga mu First Chronicles chapter 22 verse 19. First Chronicles chapter 22 verse 19. Leero njasookera mu kusoma nga sinaba nakugamba kintu kyonna. Egambye, now determine in your mind and heart. Now determine in your mind and heart. Ekitegeeza bagamba now kitegeeza waliwo ebyayogerwa, waliwo ebyakolebwa, waliwo ebyagambibwa ne tubanga tetukikoze, naye kati bagambye nti now, kati leero, determine in your mind and in your heart. Tube bamalirivu mu birowoozo byaffe ne ku mitima gyaffe. Excuse me. Ndero beera mumalirivu mu birowoozo byo ne mu mutima gwo. Yes, tade kiyinza kuba kikulemye, duli kiyinza kuba kyagaana, walokokako n'ogwa, waliwo eki wali oyiyiza ne kirema. Mukama waffe yebazibwe. Leero determine, mukama waffe yebazibwe. Now determine with your mind and heart. Bible ndale gambye, now devote your heart and soul. Mukama waffe yebazibwe. Wewe yo wenyikire, wenyikemu n'omutima gwo n'omwoyo gwo. Mukama waffe yebazibwe. Hallelujah. Aha, kiba kitegeeza ki? Yesterday oyinza kuba walemereddwa, duliyo oyinza kuba walemwa, waliwo ekyakusumbuwa ne kigaana, naye Katonda agambye leero maliriza, leero
ma bera mwete lero la bila dalanti omala yo ochikola bantu banji basesetuka ne bava ku mazema bafe basesetuka ne bava ku mugendo ate bava ku mugendo kati na yesalira omusango juzi mchala wange yali akyogerako nti abantu esalira omusango ne tugwira dane tugamba a kati kitegeza katona tachi anjagala mukama wafe yebazibwe katona tachi anjagala kitege nagwa anze sikya ina kyende maso ga katonda a agambye lero malirira sincha sidirero biribireke bala kino malirira mu mutima gwo no mu bidowozo byo oba no moyo gwo
oku katugenda seeking the Lord your God
okunonya katonda kabako mutonzi wo mukama wafe bazibwe maliriza malirira wewe yo byenyigire mu mukunonyereza mukunonya mukunonya amaso ga katonda mukunonya amaso go munuzi wo mukama wafe bazibwe
then get started building the Lord's God's sanctuary so that you may bring the ark of the Lord's covenant and the holy articles of God to the temple that is to be built for the name of Yahweh
but na mala kwewayo mukunonya katonda mukutegeera byayagala mukutegeera biki byayagala muwemaye muyekalu ye kijja kutwanguira okutandika omulimu gw'okuzimbira katonda tuzimbe ennyumba ya katonda tuleete ebikwatwa vessels tuleete ebiri byonna ebibeera ebibitifying emeeza ennyumba ya katonda ng'emeeza ng'essanduuko y'omugaati covenant box nga lampstand etaala weyimirira anointing oil njolonkubulira yeekaalu ya katonda munda ebibeeramu mukama waffe yeebazibwe nga awabeera holy of holies wonna tereezeewo mukama yeebazibwe tutereeze empya ze tuteekewo puulu we banaabira kwegamba buli kimu kyonna tusikinge God with all our heart ate kankubuulire mukyala wange brother wange muganda wange mulamu wange jajjange maama taata gwe muvubuka muwala nazaala wange buli muntu yenna gwe tukola naye emirimu tokigamba nti ngenda kikola enkya kitandike leero mukyala wange wanagambye nti yes Lord I'm ready to seek you now teka kona akagambo nawe oli agambye 100% emirundi gingi leka tumunonye bantu mwekamba buulireko ndabye ebintu bingi nali ndabyeko omuntu gwe basuula mu ntaana ng'embwa ntaina wasabira yali asabira ba protestant nabanga takyasaba we yafiiranga tasaba ne bagamba ntakyali memba nabulwa muziika bamuyitanga Wednesday abampuliriza abekyegegwa muyinza kunjulira emabega wa police bamusuulayo ng'embwa waliwo omulala bamuyita bone ali kiranzi olukuba erigenda mpala ngova kyegegwa ye bamuziika ne wabulaayo ayogerwa ng'omuweereza ne wabaawo omuvubuka bamuyita jogindo naye kati yafa ye n'agamba leka bamweziikire kyali waabwe bati yakigamba leka tweziikire kyali waffe n'addira walagi n'ayuwayo ne boogera ebyo bagamba byeboogera n'akwata n'akacupa akajudde akatoka akanaaka pepsicola kalimu walagi n'akasiba n'akasuulayo ne baziika ebyo byonna biri mu nsi muno mukama yebazibwe mulimu omulala ekkanisa gye nali mpeerezaako ku kyalo ekyo waliwo yali afudde mukama waffe yebazibwe ne wabula muziika yali mukatuliki ne wabula bamuziika nti abadde tawaayo biweebwayo ebyekeleziya saagala kubitugenda munyo sebimanyi nyo ekiwanvu naye ate bwe mba njagadde kubyogerako mba mbimanyi naye for now kati siki ekindeese nti abadde tasaba kwegamba ne bamuleka ne beegayirira abalokole tuzikise n'engamba you know what kano ke kakyansi tubuulire abantu enjiri n'enyimirira n'engamba kati enjiri yaffe abalamu tutegeere bwe tulaga tumanye destination yaffe tutatandike kunoonya ebyo ebirungi bye tusaanidde okuba nabyo mukama waffe yeebazibwe leka tunoonye mukama n'amagezi gaffe na byonna ebiri mu ffe bantu mmwe tunoonye katonda teri miaka nti ah kansoke nywemu nywemu kansoke ndaye nsoke nkolemo bwa malaya kansoke nkube ngumi kansoke nkole kino nechiri nja kulokoka unga maze miaka yange nge ebiri kagamanga bintami ani ako ani amanyolo nakulwencha kinale tambula mubwo kuzama manyi ngakugamba I'm happy that my prophet has said she is ready to start seeking God. Me, I'm seeking, but I want to seek Him more. Bantu mwetegira amazima nagatufule baddembe. Bwetumala nga tulese ebiweebwa ebintu bya Katonda nga yeekaalu ye nnungi balyoke bagiwandiikeko erinnya erigisaanidde nti weema ya Katonda yeekaalu ya Katonda ekifo kya Katonda bwonna weetereza abantu bagenda kuwandiikako erinnya praise be the Lord Jesus ogenda kubaako erinnya ngamba yeekaalu gwe mutima gwo ngamba ekyo ky'ogenda kutereza gwe mutima gwo n'ebyo ebikwato by'ogenda kuteekamu kwe kugaba kwe kugumiisiriza kwe kukkiriza kwe kusinza kwe kwewaayo kwe kubuulira enjiri kwe kulagula kwe kukola ebirungi ogenda kubanga owulira emirembe rikata ya kuyiba bakasiki ya kuna maka ya kisiki ya kabaka kiribo mukama agenda kubanga akutegeera eyeekaalu tobasooka kulaba eri ebizimbe ya bloka zetukuba zetukuba netujja netuzimba naye sooka olaba omutima gwo nga ggwe omutima gwo bwonna omala gutereza kasito n'obuulira obulamu bwo n'obuulira ebirowoozo byo n'obigamba ke kaseera birowoozo mmwe ke kaseera mamwe mwoyo wange mutusinze mukama wamanyi riki yakabaya riko shikiria agenda kukuvira yo naye akugambe kati munange nono muyekalo teekamu okwagala teekamu okusonyiwa teekamu okugumisiriza teekamu okukkiriza teekamu okusinza teekamu okwenenyanga teekamu okubuulira enjiri osange nga yeekaalu yo gwe mutima gwo nga gujjudde mulinnya la Yesu mukama agenda kikukolera rika yitibuku yakaya mukama agenda kukuvirayo naye nga nawe olina ky'omulaze gwasooka atontegedde gwasooka riki yaba gwasooka nze asooka mukama agambye halleluya now determine gwalina okusooka n'omaliriza gwalina kusooka n'otamibwa ebizibu ebikukuba gwalina sooka n'otamibwa challenge gwalina sooka n'otamibwa ebizibu gwalina sooka n'otamibwa saako gy'oliko eyo roundabout gy'otavaako gwasooka kutamibwa ebi red robots red traffic lights ezisibye nga gwe tosimbula gwalina sooka n'otamibwa ebyo relationship ye etakenda mu maaso it's you who is supposed to get tired of the situation that you are in it's you who is supposed to get tired of all the calamities around you. It's you who is supposed to get tired of all the mountains before you and after you. Then you tell God that here I am, God. This is my heart, Lord. I'm here to sanctify it so that I can build a temple in my heart. And there you can dwell. I have to bring all the articles of God. We were in first, and we are still in First Chronicles chapter 22 verse 19. To all my sisters and my brothers who have just joined, I want to tell you, no one will determine for you. No one will devote for you. It's you and you alone. That now it's my time. Don't say tomorrow. Don't say the other day. Don't say let me first booze. Let me first club. Let me first chill. Let me first be a prostitute. Let me first practice gay, lesbian, homosexual. Let me first kill. Let me first rob. Let me first cheat. Let me do this. And then after, maybe 3 years, maybe 4 years, maybe 10 years, then I'll be born again. Then I will get salvation. Your salvation is now. Your salvation is just hand. Just start building the temple, which is your heart. Bring all the good articles and put them in. Check. What are those that you have built? What are those that you have done? What are those that you've tried to put in existence? Check. How many girls have you made them to lose their Christ? You, a young man, and you, man who is there. Instead of building the house of God and bringing all the articles of God, we are busy confusing the praising team whispers. We are busy trying to entice those young girls who are preaching, those pastors and the ministers' wives. We are busy destroying. Hallelujah, hallelujah. For instead of going to preach, instead of going to praise God, instead of saying, it's my turn, Amos, I have to go and do this at least for God. And so that God can count on that and say, Amos, During his presence, he did ABCD. But instead of that, for us, we are busy destroying, breaking, casting down everything that our brothers and sisters are building. You know that someone is married, but you are busy enticing him. You know that someone is praising Tim Wasper, but you are busy trying to practice fornication with that person. You, instead of going back and looking for God and saying, this is my time, this is my time, this is my time, I have to show God that here I am. For you said, there is nowhere we can build a temple. In heaven is where you sit. He on us is your footstool. But you told us, if we build the temple in our heart, there you will dwell. From today, I'm busy bringing all the materials so that I can build the heart. Then I bring all the articles and the articles of God. I put them inside so that you can dwell there, so that the sweet aroma that comes from there may be good. Hello, my sisters, my brother. So that you can sacrifice on the heart of God. In the temple of God, there is where they sacrifice. When did you last first sacrifice, my sister? Wakomadi yoku sacrificing, wakomadi yoku waye kiwebwayo, ekiwebwayo chokwagala, ekiwebwayo chokusinza, love offering, tithes. When did you stop? When did you end? When did you remember that I last gave in the church? I last did in church. I last praised in church. I last prayed. I last went there with a devoted heart. Not to go there so the pastors can see you. Not to go there because your friend is going there. Not to go there because you found that your family were going in that church. Not that. This is the time that God has given us to exalt him, to bless his name, to glorify his name. But you can't do it when your heart is having zigzag, when your heart is meandering, when your heart is not clear with your God. Bro, hello, hello. I want to tell you, today you're hearing this word. There is a time when you not hear it. Today you are seeing Bibles being opened. There is a time when the Bibles will not be opened. Today you are seeing many media people are there preaching. And Amos is also inclusive in those that are preaching. There is a time when you not see that. There is a time when churches will be totally closed. This was a temporary closing. There is a time when the churches will be closed, the Bibles will be burnt to you. They find you talking about Christ. They cut your neck, they shoot you, they moor you, they can even persecute you, they can give you heavy punishment that you have never seen, because they have just found you speaking goodness about God. But now, if you have got this chance, use it and use it well in the mighty name of Jesus. Then Jesus himself will exalt you and will say, this is my man. Then they will write a name on that church, the Bible says. Now determine in your heart and in your mind, seeking Lord your God, get started building the Lord God's sanctuary, and that you may bring the ark of the God's covenant and the holy articles of God to the temple that is to be built for the name of Yahweh. Excuse me. There is a name of Yahweh that is supposed to be built, my sister. There is a name of Yahweh that is supposed to be put. But remember, hello, I bring good news. That name is not going to be written on that church that you are building with your brothers and sisters and your pastors down there. No, they will write a name here on your forehead. They will write a name on your heart saying, Apostle of God, Goresi, Prophetess of God, Sister Mabuza, Minister of God, Brother Rogers, Pastor of God, Sister Edith, Administrator in the church, Sister Drulens, Choir Leader. They will give you names. They will write them. Oh, that one is a saint of God. Oh, why? Because you have taken your time. You have determined to build your heart as a temple of God. So whatever correspondence will be coming out, it will be yielding Jesus. It will be speaking about God. But we have got a problem. For us, we say tomorrow, the yesterday, that day. Wait. You give it time. You keep prolonging. Prolong, my sister. Prolong, my dear. But time is not prolonging. Yesterday you were having another year. You were having some minutes in this life. Today you have added another day. Tomorrow you will add another day. Time is not your best friend. Time is moving. Whether you allow it or not, it will keep going. But are you moving with it? Are you ready to reach your destination? Ah, yeah. there is a man who was beaten by, they killed him by, with the, they used stones to kill him. That was Stephen or Stephen, those who know him. At the end, towards the end, towards death, he said, "My Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing." Forgive them, they don't know what they are doing. I very much say, and I'm sure, that Stephen was the same as Christ, moved as the way Jesus moved. He never moved on right and left. He kept his strength. He kept his straight line. Praise be the Lord Jesus. Because even Jesus, when he was about to breathe his last breath, he said, "Forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing." Hallelujah. I want my sister, I want my brother, and also me, at that time, we say, "Forgive them, they don't know what they are doing." You tell them, "I know where I'm going. I can see my road is clear. I can see where I'm going. I'm seeing angels are there coming for me." But when people are dying, some, they start doing like this. Like when they are dying, they faint, because what they are seeing is not good. They are seeing the agents of the devil coming for them. But if someone is resting from his work, hallelujah, when someone is resting from his work, I want to tell you the thing, like how Daniel rested from his work. The Bible says, "And I heard a loud voice saying, Behold, blessed are those who die in Christ Jesus. Yea, they rest, and their work rest with them." Amen. For them, they just rest. Then it's not dying. It's to other people, to those who don't know the power of the cross, they may think is death. But to those who have worked for God, they rest from their work, and their work follows them. Praise be to Jesus. I want you and me to reach that extent where I will say, "Forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing." Where I will start speaking the words that Jesus spoke. Jesus said, "You will do what I did, even more than what I did." But don't think that we'll only do the miracles, the prophecy style. No, we have even to speak the words that Jesus spoke. Hallelujah. I'm winding up. Don't get tired of me. 1 Chronicles chapter 28 verse 9. Hallelujah. 1 Chronicles chapter 28 verse 9 to 10. "As for you," put your name, "as for you," here they say Solomon, "as for you, Sister Mabuza, as for you, Rogers, as for you, Goresi, as for you, Amos," we are in 1 Chronicles chapter 28, verse 9 and 10. Here they said, "As for you," very good, God bless you, prophetess. "As for you, prophetess," put there your name. Don't say, "I'll do it tomorrow." Don't say, "I'll start seeking God yesterday, I mean the other day." Seek him today. Hallelujah. Seek him today. Someone is telling me they are not tired, they need me more. But still, you have to see me in the evening, because even in the evening we have got what to say. Hallelujah. At 6:30 we are coming. The Bible says that, "As for you, Amos, my son, now know the God of your father, and serve him with all your heart and willing mind." When you are serving God, you have to serve him with all your heart and with your willing mind. Don't serve him because your husband is a Christian. Don't serve him because your wife is a minister of God. Don't serve him because your boss is a churchgoer. Serve him with all your heart, with a willing mind. It's you to have that willing capacity. God gave you the power of will. So you have to serve him with that will. Oina kumuweleza ngo muweleza ngo cho kolo chikakasa. Nga no mutima gogu wadeyo. Dala. In the mighty name of Jesus. Then, "For the Lord searches every heart and understands the intentions of every thought." Ya katonda alaba mitima na jikebera na tegera nebilo wozo biafibia tugenda ko. He will always such as our heads, and he will always understand the thoughts, the intentions we are to do. Some people have got intentions, they are with you, but with the other hidden intentions, with the hidden agenda. But God, such as all, understands every and everything in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. "As for me, Mabuza," yes, Princess Mabuza, "as for you and as for me, we will serve the Lord," not by our lips. Mm-mm. We have to serve him starting from the inner man. My bishop, Pastor Senfuma Stephen, has got a church talking about inner man. Ministry International. In a man, your Holy Spirit, that soul inside you has to start fellowshipping, praising God, serving God. Then it will come out. Whatever is filled by the heart, the mouth speaks. Then you will speak. You will speak good tidings. As for me, Drola, as for me, Goddess, please you put for me, as for me, Amos, I also, hallelujah, want to serve my almighty God with all my heart. I'm tired of serving human beings. I'm tired of serving because people will have to see me serving. I'm tired of doing things in a pretense way. We have to stop pretending so that we can do things in the actual way, in the real realm. Then God can stand there and bless us in the mighty name of Jesus. I have chosen this, that I will choose, I will serve God for the rest of my life. Hallelujah. Amen. Then the Bible says, if you seek him, he will be found of you. But if you forsake him, he will reject you forever. Realize now that the Lord has chosen you to build a house for the sanctuary. Be strong and do it. Realize now, Sister Mabuza, Sister Drolens, Prophetess, Amos, Rogers, Edith, Alice, Lydia, Martha, and everyone, our other minister from Uganda, JK, everyone who is listening, realize now that God has chosen you. He has, praise be the Lord Jesus, hallelujah, has chosen you. It's not Amos, it's not Gorethi, it's not by a ballot paper, it's not by vote, it's by God himself. Oh, what a God, what good God we serve. That song. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Even angels bow down. Hallelujah. Let us change our mentality in serving God. Let us change our approach in searching, even in serving God. Let us change our appearance. Let us do things. I have seen people, you talk this, you walk that. You talk this, you eat that. You talk this, you move that. No, don't confuse God. Put on well, dress clearly. Brush the teeth. People will want to hear your breath. You were born again, but when you speak to someone, say, I have understood it, I will do it. He has not understood it, because the breath that is coming from you is more than, I don't know, it's speaking. I'm sorry to use it. No, brush your teeth, clean the armpit, the beards, if you're a man, hair cut it. If you're a lady, you know how to do your stuff. Don't exaggerate it. There is a time, 2 days, 3 days back down the line, I was with my wife. We were walking in Malabarstad. Those who know Malabarstad, one of the, I don't know how I can call it, one of the simple market or local market around the Pretoria. So we saw a lady. I asked my wife what happened to her face. Then my wife told me she had put makeup in the morning. So makeup was trying to expire or was just asking for leave. So maybe the lady did not realize that the makeup is busy seeking the leave. So she never attended to makeup. So makeup did it itself. It escaped. So the lady was having here, color, green color, purple color, yellow color. My daughter is always nyanta saying color, purple color, green color, yellow color, white color, black. So the lady was mixed. You can't even understand. No, if you lady put something, not exaggerate, so that you can keep in a manner that will please everyone. Then let your breath be fine. If you are speaking to your sister and my sister, this and that, then some, okay, yes, yeah. But for you, by the mighty Magam, hallelujah, amen. I'm busy, I will be seeing you. Why? Someone is not busy, but because of the breath, let us be ready. We men, our nails are long, like I don't know, like we are ego. Are you practicing ego crow? Cut them. Who told you that men should have big nails? Even my wife, I advised her not to have these nails too long. She's not practicing ego cross, she's not a Chinese. Let us do things that will do everything in a manner that will please God. We men, we have a problem. Our pants can be visited 7 times before we wash it. You put it, then there is the way we wash it. When you pick it from the line, you do. That's what the way men wash their pants. You think it's still fine. You put on, no! If you have used it, meaning whether it's smelling or it's not smelling, it needs to visit the bathtub and you clean it for the other use. Praise be the Lord Jesus. Let us make our God happy. Hallelujah. Now, be strong and do it. The Bible says, realize now that the Lord has chosen you to build you, to build a house for the sanctuary. Be strong and do it now. I advise you. It's God Himself that has chosen you, Goretti, Princess, Amos. It's God who has chosen us. So let us advise ourselves by accepting to build His temple, which is our heart. Then let us be strong and do it. No one will do it for you. Hallelujah. Praise be the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the Lord Jesus. Don't make me laugh, you people. I want to tell you one thing. It's us who must be strong, not God to be strong. Sister Drulens, God is not going to be strong. It's you to be strong and to do it. You have understood me. Prophetess, when you decide something, do it. When we decide to do ABCD, let us do it. Princess, when you decide to, let us do it. We are aging. We have to be married. We are aging. We have to service our marriage. We are aging. We have to have, we have to live in a happier life in our relationship. We are aging. Let our ministry be booming. We are aging. Let us show people that enough is enough. We are getting there. Rogers, we are aging. It's a time when you start your eye to open and see who is that one that is supposed to be my rib. You get that rib and you fix it. That is your wife. Praise be the Lord Jesus. This is a time when we have to start doing things and do them in a manner that will please God. Not tomorrow, the other day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise be the Lord Jesus. I encourage you. I advise you. Seek ye God and His kingdom and the righteousness that is in it, then others will follow you. Praise be the Lord Jesus. When I was telling my wife, that was 2015, late 2015, that you will be ministering, I see you a great prophetess. She was seeing me like a negative. She was seeing me like a TV, black and white. She was seeing me like someone who is talking parables. Yesterday was supposed to minister in that prayer service at night, midnight. Then because she saw that I was tired and I'm not feeling well, she never bothered to wake me up. Yet me, I was watching. Then she arose herself. She did whatever she did. She went and stood in the gap and started taking people in the presence of God. Praise be the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now she's preaching. Now she's reminding me. Now she's listening. Even yesterday, she got a vision. Every time she's getting visions, she's getting voices. Now she's a prophetess. Now she's even wondering. The daughter is busy also preaching. These are the things that when they are telling you, you will not consider them. You will not acknowledge. You will not understand that they are real until they come into existence. Today, she's a minister of God. But that day when I was saying, she thought maybe I'm disenticing because men, every man, whenever he's coming to someone's life, will come with a story, will come with enticing words. So she thought maybe I'm a kind of those people who, hallelujah, will come with such enticing words. I don't play. But don't say that you don't play with me. Me, whatever I say, even if we are playing, I will be meaning it. My wife knows I don't joke like the joke that will take me into destruction. Even when I'm joking, I will joke in the line that is right. So today she's a preacher. So this is a minister. She has no escape plan. She has to be there. She has to humble herself. So is Drulens. So is Rogers. So is his sister Mabuza. I want to leave you with one thing. And this is another advice. Delaying to get saved is delaying your destiny. Delaying to get saved is delaying your destiny and delaying those people that are supposed to be saved, to be won by Christ through you. Secondly, delaying to serve God is delaying yourself. Amen. Delaying to serve God is delaying yourself. You can't tell God that. No. Elijah said it, that all the prophets have died. Take your servant. God told him, I have got 7,000 that they haven't yet done anything. You think that you are busy hurting God. You're not hurting God. God is busy on his mission. But to choose you is also a blessing to you. You must accept it and you must welcome it. Embrace what God has given you. I always tell my wife, I always tell her, and even I can tell her now, some people are looking for prophets. They make appointment. They book days and time. Some people look for praise God, for prophets or apostles. They even end up falling in traps of fake apostles, fake prophets, fake men of God. But I told her, she got a chance, a golden chance, that she is cooking for a prophet. She is the wife for the apostle. Every day, every minute, she's seeing the servant of God every minute. So she shouldn't get tired if the prophet is calling. She shouldn't get tired. And again, she should make sure that she gets everything, she gets everything that is in the apostle, that is in this prophet, because God has given you this blessing. God has given you this gift. Use it well, utilize it. At night, wake him up, apostle, this and that. My husband, this and that. My prophet, this and that. Make him, utilize him, make him busy. You always see the way people, they call me. The way people, they call me, you are seeing. Sometimes I don't rest. When you are supposed also now to be busy, you get everything, everything. Abaganda bagamba nti akanyonyake wala ateke kaliyes olusiringanyi. Na hizi chemanyi mchala wangi, watu sekati, kekanyonyiko kumpi atene olusiringanyi. Kalulia, lwakuba kati ndaba watuse mukama yebazibwe ndabira ddala ebintu agenda abikwato enyiriri the way she stalks on a stand verse, the way she's getting the insight, the way God is using her. I feel even if God is taking me, there is someone that I will leave behind. Hallelujah. I very much know that even if I go now, my wife will stand. Edith will stand. Julens is there, Roger is there, JK is there, Martha is there, praise be the Lord Jesus, Alice is there, because they have seen the way God is using me. They will not tell you, Sister Mabuza, people will not tell you that they haven't yet seen what God is doing through Apostle Amos. They shouldn't lie to you. Tell Sister Goresi to tell you more. Sister Mabuza, I know it's your workmate. Praise be the Lord Jesus. Let us now, those people who were with Jesus, like Peter, John, and James, the brother of John, they would utilize Jesus. They would go with him everywhere. It is only those people even entering to raise the boy who was dead. He entered with them. Even on the mountain, he would go with them. Everywhere, he would go with them. For them, they utilized the time they had with Jesus. And even when they went after Jesus, they were too strong and they did it. So I very much know, you who are next to me, you who are near me, you will be strong and do it. I very much know, God is building the church. God is making sons of thunder the foundation for people that will never stumble, will never get back setbacks, will never have problems. Why? Because you will understand the doctrine and the teaching of God. May the good God bless you, love you, strengthen you in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm Apostle Amos. I am humbled. I'm living with my wife, Prophetess Goresi Rwabhoro, and I'm having my sisters. All of you who are watching me, you are my sisters and you are my brother. I love you. I love you big. Praise be the Lord Jesus. Don't miss this evening when we are having a program called Ask Your Pastor. May the God bless you. I love you. Bye-bye.